Greetings, this is Bloodrill, and welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity, where I just recruited Aether, probably. Who knows? Okay. 5 athletics, 2 survival, 2 stealth, cost and recovery, defender, find experience, yeah, okay. Wreck Weapon, Foxes, Ruffian, what's that? Passive. Self, plus 6 to accuracy with saber, stiletto, club, pistol. Aha, alright. And what's your weapon? What's your inventory? 16 might. Saber, cool. Very nice. Alright, let's go and save first. And go talk to the... yep, the mill guy, but also check in here. I think I never actually got in there, right? Yeah, after I tried to steal from them. Let's see. Why is he throwing them apples? Something about the legacy and about the responsibilities. What is it? Is this more white or is it my... I think it's more white, yeah. Okay, I guess it's a maid. A glowing orb of energy flies from her hand and strikes the apple, causing it to explode. Okay, the man's face changes, anger joined by fear, looking like he's trying to decide if running or attacking is the best course of action. The second woman has started chanting again, her hand glowing, her eyes narrowing. This woman steps in front of her, placing herself between her love and their attacker. She touches her face, gently stroking it while whispering calming words. A kiss, the woman's countenance changes, she calms, her eyes softening, her lips regaining the lost smile. The first woman smiles again as well and kisses the other. Wizards come, the man behind them say, and the two women turn to face him, staring him down defiantly. They join hands and begin walking again, moving past him without so much as a sideways glance. Okay. Is this the second woman? Maybe. Maybe not. Aha. So one of them killed a woman. Could be the other's former lover. Maybe, I'm not sure. And I still can't talk to these people. I will need to look that up soon. But for now, let's proceed, finishing the Miller's quest. And then, I'm not sure if I should go to the temple and try to clear that place. Or I should go to the bear, try to kill it again. seeing his father kneeling before the block, neck exposed. Okay. Okay, interesting. Those backstories are really interesting. And where the hell is the Miller? That way. Nope. Come on, this way. Good job. That's safe too.
Hail, traveler.
You're back. Have you had any luck with Swinmur? I spoke to him. I've convinced him to leave your family in peace. Why, that's... really? That's great news. I wasn't sure you'd get through to him. They are out of their minds with drink half the time. I owe you a great debt. Here. He pulls a coin purse from his hip and puts it towards you. Today's earning to show my appreciation. Nah, I don't need it. Actually, wait a minute. My goal is to be filthy rich, as I said to Kaliska. But not from profiting from others' misery. Alright. I mean, they are starving in here, so taking the money, perhaps not the best choice. So, should I go... where? Actually, there are more places here, I think. This is the cow place. How about here? No, the blacksmith, yeah. Let's check it out. Well, it's a big place. Commoner, guard, apprentice, a couple of dudes you can soul watch, I guess. And the blacksmith. Alright, let's see what you have. What? That was weird. Yep, we did that already. The other guy. I guess it's under. Alrighty. This Aumawa. Okay. These are the tallest guys, if I remember correctly. The tallest race. Welcome, you are the first new face I've seen in quite some time. Is it a shop? Yep. The stock's not what it used to be. What happened? Just don't have the supplies. Been expecting the next delivery for near a week now, and I haven't seen a sign of it. Have to expect they were hit by bandits. All my workers ran off with the wagon themselves. Is that about the bandits? The dire situation in villages like this and the exodus to the cities has created far too many opportunities for unscrupulous sorts. If you happen to be headed that way, maybe you could keep an eye for a supply wagon. They'd be cutting through the Black Meadow, I expect. Okay. As is most of our weapons, go to his grease. Sure, I'll find your supplies. The Black Meadow, where is the Black Meadow, by the way? Let me see. Oh, that's the place I need to go. This is where I am. I don't see any Black Meadow. We'll see. So I guess I shouldn't buy actually stuff now. I should wait until I have the discount. Also, I really like that they have trees as tables, stuff like that. It's pretty cool. Let's save and see if we can actually loot. Nope, fair enough. So that was the wrong button. I don't understand why some people don't mind, some people mind when you loot their stuff. Not sure. Doesn't make much sense. Alright, is there any other kind of shop around here? Let's go that way. Doesn't go that way actually. Okay. It was rather uneventful. Fine. This area was in the beta, which I played like for 5 minutes. I'm pretty sure it had an alchemist, but I can't seem to find the place. Smith, Ingress House, Windmill, Exits. Maybe not. Alright, I think I'll go explore a bit. Let's see. This leads to Margran's Fork. I want to see if different exits lead to different places. Did I go here? Nope. Aufra. And a cat. A dire wooden woman is standing in front of the fireplace, humming a quiet tune to herself. Or perhaps to her unborn child, for she is clearly quite pregnant.
Greetings.
Well, finally, I was starting to think the woman makes a startled noise once she turns around and sees you. Oh, I'm sorry, I was expecting someone else. Can I help you? I got just arrived in... sure. Were you with one of the caravans? Master Odimas? Yes. I was. I'm afraid the rest of the caravan was killed. Actually, yeah, you know, Dima. He doesn't usually come this way, but they say he's a reliable fellow. Wait, what do you say, new? I'm sorry, but the caravan was attacked. I was the only one to survive. Aufra covers her mouth with a hand, eyes go wide with horror. Was he the husband? For a few moments, she mutters nothing but a strangled, voiceless gasping. Her eyes brim me with tears. I knew. Maybe not. Oh, it's a sister. Oh, right, it's a sister, yeah. Kaliska's sister, right? Yeah. I told her it was a dangerous path to take. Kaliska was always so certain she could take on any danger. Oh, my poor sister. If only I hadn't called her here. Kaliska mentioned that she thought you needed help. Perhaps I can provide some assistance. That's kind of you to offer, but I don't know if I could impose this on you. It's not a small favor. I'm worried about the baby, about the legacy. I told Kaliska as much as I could, but all I know is that for a long time now, every child born in Gilded Vale has been soulless, empty. It's happened to so many mothers, and Lord Redrig, he's exiled all of them. That guy's a fucking idiot. With my Hathhorn gone, I don't know how I'd manage if I lost my home too. I hoped Kaliska would help me. They say Ranga, the old midwife, knows a way to prevent a child. Also, probably not true. But she moved south to Anslug's compass 2 seasons ago. Okay. So. I'll give you coin to pay for her with. You needn't trouble yourself with that. I think it's a drink she functions out of, well, I'm not sure. Okay. The lagoon to the south. You'll have to cross the wilds to get there. Okay. Interesting. Is there anything else?
Well met, friend.
Northeast, okay. Cool. Alright, we'll get another quest. Let's see now if exiting from the north actually changes anything. Okay, that was a mistake, but alright. The fuck? The usurper. Aha. Oh, okay. Their backstories are quite interesting. I don't think I can go that way. I think this is the way I came, so this probably will lead me back to the... I wonder if there's anything this way. So let's try to take an exit. I'm not sure it actually matters, just want to be sure. There is no exit here, fine. Ah, there it is. Yeah, no, I don't think there is any chance. Alright. Yes. I will try to go back and kill the bear, see what happens. For now, I'll end this episode here. Thank you for watching. Subscribe, like, leave a comment if you want to. And I will see you next time.